The planet is frying, and we need to do something about it.
Our climate team wakes up every morning asking themselves one question, which is, how can you reduce greenhouse gases?
Our dependence on oil is a problem for several reasons.
Once people try plugging in, you don't ever want to go back to the gas station.
What's driving plug-in hybrids is three things: cleaner, cheaper, domestic.
Well, plug-in hybrids, I think, are sort of the killer app in automotive technology. They're the best of both worlds between electric cars and the flexibility of a hybrid. So a plug-in hybrid is one vehicle where maybe your first 40 miles of the day are all electric. Monday through Friday, you may never use gasoline. But if you wanted to drive to Vegas on the weekend, you have the flexibility to do that, and you can put gasoline in the tank as a backup. We call plug-in hybrids electric vehicles with safety nets.
The big breakthrough comes with the plug-in hybrid. You add a larger battery, and you can add the second fuel source, electricity.
By having a plug-in hybrid, they get to drive on the power that they're charging overnight, several kilowatt hours. They, which is maybe 5 cents a kilowatt hour in many parts of the United States. That's essentially like driving on, let's say, 1-2 cents a mile.
We're seeing individuals and companies like Google who are willing to use these conversion cars to show this technology is real, it is here today, it is possible, so how come you, the automotive companies, aren't making them yet?
So Google is taking a number of steps to advance plug-in hybrid electric vehicles. First, we're converting 6 cars, 4 Priuses and 2 Ford Escapes, to plug-in hybrid electrics. Secondly, we are going to add about 100 vehicles to our corporate fleet.
Well, I think it's important for government to set standards toward making cleaner cars, because what we know for sure is Detroit doesn't have a history of wanting to do it on their own.
For alternative energy sources like wind and solar, where you might not necessarily be generating the power exactly when you need it, you can store it and then delay when it's used by storing it in the battery.
Vehicle to grid is the big game changer in this whole situation. The idea is that batteries in cars can become distributed energy storage systems for the entire power grid. The power grid has this problem, it doesn't have a place to store energy.
The whole idea of vehicle to grid, or V2G, is that you have to have the power available when the grid needs it.
Google is working with our utility, PG&E, and others to help develop standards for vehicle-to-grid and to do tests with our demonstration fleet to see, you know, how practical it is, what kind of problems we run into, and how can we really make this work.
So it's a nice coming together of demand and supply. Large supply at night that the vehicles can used to charge up, and high demand during peak periods during the day, where those same vehicles can sell that electricity back to the power company.
These cars, in essence, allow you to take the renewable energy, the solar energy, let you use it when you need it, and power back the grid when you're not using it.
That means that you're providing a revenue stream to clean vehicles.
If we went to sleep tonight and woke up tomorrow morning and all of the cars in the country were plug-in hybrids, if they were charging at night, we could power 82% of them with today's grid. So that means that we don't have to build any more power plants to power our cars.
The more we transition to electricity, the more opportunity we will have to use those renewable fuels, whether it's wind or solar, whether it's on your house or as part of the national grid. So electric cars are the only cars that get cleaner over time.
You're starting to see a lot of the same type of excitement that greeted the birth of the internet. There are people investing in this area that weren't investing before. Areas that are relevant to both the batteries for plug-in hybrids and to the cellulosic fuels.
The best way to get people to plug in is to give them the option in the first place. Once people try plugging in, you don't ever want to go back to the gas station.
Once all the systems are in place, there'll be more customers than we can make cars for.
I call this a growing coalition between the tree huggers, the do-gooders, the sodbusters, the cheap hawks, the evangelicals, the utility shareholders, the mom-and-pop drivers, and Willie Nelson.
The reason that we finally came to this naming of Recharge It is because you can recharge the car from the sun, you can recharge the grid from the car, and you can recharge our enthusiasm for trying to tackle the problems of global warming all at once. So, rechargeit.org seems like a perfect name for us.